Son into the world to save sinners, bring you his pardon and peace, now and forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Creator God, you also made us, for you made us all in your image. May we discern you in all that we see and serve you in all that we do. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Our first reading is taken from Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 12, beginning at the 4th verse. For as in one body we have many members, and not all the members have the same function, so we, who are many, are one body in Christ, and individually we are members one of another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us. Prophecy in proportion to faith, ministry in ministry, the teacher in teaching, the exhorter in exhortation, the giver in generosity, the leader in diligence, the compassionate in cheerfulness. Let love be genuine, hate what is evil, hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honour. Do not lag in zeal, be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We stand to sing our praises.
Thank you. of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Luke.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Once while Jesus was standing beside the lake of Gennesaret, and the crowd was pressing in on him to hear the word of God, he saw two boats there at the shore of the lake. The fishermen had gone out of them and were washing their nets. He got into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, and asked him to put a little way from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon,
"Put out into deep water and let down your nets for a catch."
Simon answered,
"Master, we have worked all night long but have caught nothing. Yet, if you say so, I will let down the nets."
When they had done this, they caught so many fish that their nets were beginning to break. So they signalled to their partners in the boats to come and help them. And they came and filled both boats, so that they began to sink. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying,
"Go away from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man."
For he and all who were with him were amazed at the catch of fish that they had taken. And so were James, John, and sons of Zebedee, who were partners with Simon. Then Jesus said to Simon,
"Do not be afraid. From now on, you will be catching people."
When they had brought their boats to shore, they left everything and followed him. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Good morning to all of you. I've got a challenge for you, a bit of a bake-off. So I'd like you all, as a team, to bake some cakes. So there's a recipe down there, plenty of ingredients for you to work as a team to make some cakes. So you've got about 30 minutes to do that, and I'll be back to see how you do. So work well together. See you soon. Start baking.
Well, I'm not working with them.
Let's work together.
Guys, we have the recipe. We're meant to work as a team.
So let's see how everyone's doing. Oh, you're all in different groups. And how are you doing by yourself?
Patrick and Francis are working with them.
Okay. And over here, how are you two doing?
This is going well.
Okay. Oh, now you've got the recipe, so how's that going for you?
Eggshells in the cake batter.
That wasn't me.
Yes, it was.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it was.
No. What was that for?
It must have been someone sabotaging us. Let's see if the other team will let us work with them.
Can we work with them?
Makes the dream work.
sparks. Get set.
In the New Testament reading from Paul's letter to the Romans, we heard about everyone's different gifts.
goodness. Dear Lord, we give thanks for our church, for the people who help us and love us. Fill the people of your church with happiness and help them to know that you are here. We pray for the leaders at Ignite, Mark, Charlotte and Sue, for all they do and all they help us with. We give thanks for all who work with the young people in church. Lord, in your mercy.
Dear Lord, we pray that you will bring peace to places of war, especially in Ukraine and Russia. We also pray for people in poverty and those who are homeless and refugees, as well as the charities that look out for and aid these people through their struggles. Particularly, we give thanks to the Tamale Fund. Help guide the leaders and politicians to make the right decisions for the best of the people in their country. We give thanks for leaders all around the world who help towards making the world a better place. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Dear Lord, we pray for our community, for our teachers, schools and parents, and all others who prepare us for the future. We pray for our shops and our farms, providing us with all we need. We also pray for the work of the GSPCA and Animal Aid. Lord, in your mercy.
Dear Lord, we pray for those who are sick and those who take care of them. We pray for the staff at the hospital, the nurses, doctors, ambulance crews, as well as the cleaners, receptionists and all who work in the offices. In the community, we pray for people who are mentally and physically unwell, especially people with anxiety and depression. We ask that God gives them comfort and support and makes them well. We pray for young people and the stresses some of them face. We pray for those on our prayer list, bless them and help them through their hard times. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Our God, sustain the talk of us so we well.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
We sing our offertory hymn, hymn number 91, Father Christopher, number 91.
with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honour. Do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Before our final hymn, we won't just stay standing for a second. I think we should say thank you to our youngsters for all they've done today in putting our service together. Give them a round of applause, you think? They've worked really hard over the last couple of months putting all the different bits of it together, so thank you very much for that. Have you got a particular song there, Sue?
We have,
because I do believe there is a birthday girl in our midst, Norma's birthday, so I think we should sing Happy Birthday Band. You ready?
Richard tomorrow.
So we'll sing to Norma and to Richard then.